How do you handle when these negative headlines are out there? I mean, it just seems like MoviePass is a company that has attracted so much interest for its size. How do you respond to those kind of the constant criticism, the negative headlines? I mean, what's it like internally, your fellow employees working at MoviePass right now?
It's really difficult. It's difficult for all of us to take so much criticism when we know we're just, you know, trying to do what we think is going to be a real positive for the industry. What's worse is the constituents in the industry, whether it's studios or exhibitors, not realizing that they are having a banner year partially because of us. I mean, believe me, the movies are good, but they're not that much better than they were last year. You know, it's not like marketing has gotten better. It's not like the movies have gotten better. No, MoviePass has re-energized the excitement and interest in movie going. So, you know, when I read all this stuff or, you know, you can't imagine the emails I get from people who, you know, say, you know, on the one hand say, you've changed my life. I now go to the movies with my wife two or three times a month. And, you know, it's rekindled our romance. To people who say, now we have a movie club. And instead of going out drinking at the bar, we go to the movies. Then we drink at the bar. But then I get emails and Facebook comments, you know, saying, you know, that if they ever see me, you know, they're going to strangle me, and you know, how dare I offer this service and then take it away, and so you have to have kind of thick skin. Remember, before we launched this new price point, I had spent a year rejected by every investor, you know, imaginable in the country. Some politely, some, you know, subtly. So I kind of learned to take rejection. You just have to be focused on the mission and ideally do a better job than I did, you know, looking in both directions.